在喀什的第三天是星期日，这一天是当地最有名的大巴扎最热闹的日子。巴扎就是集市的意思，喀什大巴扎的全称是中西亚国际贸易市场。每逢周日，来自南疆各地以及中西亚各国的商人都会聚集到这里进行交易。我们十点开集时来到这里，发现早已是人头攒动，各色商品让人目不暇接。而来自三个国家的主持人也像着了魔一样，扑向各自心仪的摊位。
这里面有很多来自中亚，还有那个，像巴基斯坦啊、南亚一些国家的。你看这个铜器非常非常非常漂亮。好，
我看一下。
马杜干海的大概八块元，
这个小壶很精美啊。啊，对，带一些民族花纹图案的。
民族花纹图案的，你有那个印度花纹图案的有？民族花纹图案的没有？
这是印度的吗？
啊，印度花纹图案的。
这也是巴基斯坦的吗，老板？
啊，这是巴基斯坦的。
这个怎么卖啊？
这个是480一对。
480一对。
对。
480一对。
Everywhere you go in this Kashgar Sunday Market, you see huge amount, array of carpets. As you can see right behind me, this is so typical of Chinese Xinjiang style. It's machine made, and you can almost see not just the characteristic from the color, but from the flower and arts and all that. It's so typically Chinese. You know, and of course, it's the typical Uyghur style with all those colors and pattern. And there's not that. You know, they have many, many artists from every part of Central Asia, from Afghanistan, Pakistan, you know. And look at this. You know, in fact, you know, they also have some from Belgium. What they call pieces that actually you can hang them on the wall. And of course, this one depicts what you call it, the style of a Uyghur. Yeah? You see all the Uyghur tribe or culture? As you can see, there are men all together sitting here, playing music, and it's really, really a beautiful piece. Yeah. Now, if you turn up and look up that way, you see something a bit more oriental, a bit more Peking style. As you can see, that blue, stunning color. And of course, that looks a bit more like Iranian, Persian, Afghanistan, yeah?
Afghanistan.
Yes, Afghanistan, yeah? Beautiful, look at that, yeah? Afghanistan. Yeah? Any Iranian, Persian here? Yeah?
Hotan.
That's from Hotan.
Tibet.
I see.
Yeah, this bazaar in Kashgar is where the world meets, you know. To me, with learning, this is a trip for learning for me about the culture. I realize this is the most important melting pot of culture, where I discover things and I want to learn more. For example, here, you have two types of saffron. You know, this is the saffron from Iran. Look at that. How much is it? 30? 30 and 1 gram is 30 yuan, it's about 3 euro. Amazing. When you think that each little piece, you know, for a flower, it's about 6 or 7 pieces of pistil, all right? And this one is cheaper, come from Tibet.
The cardamom, look at the cardamom, yeah. Look at the size of the Indian cardamom. Mm. There's two kinds of cardamom here, the big one and the large one, look at that.
The peppers,
yeah.
The cumin, yeah. And after on the other side, look at these, all the dried fruits. Look at these amazing little dried, I think, the tomatoes, yeah. Dried melon. Sweet melon, all the resin, the apricot there, look at those, with a nut inside. So beautiful. This is because we are surrounded by a lot of different countries, you know. And Kyrgyz live around here as well, the Tajik. We have a lot of different communities who live in Kashgar. Kashgar is really the most amazing melting pot of culture.
Kashgar 地处亚欧大陆的中心，具有五口通八国、一路连欧亚的得天独厚的区位优势。喀什与周边各国国际贸易历史由来已久，交往日益频繁。闻名遐迩的喀什大巴扎是经过漫长的历史发展而形成的，它是一个具有2000年历史的传统贸易市场。当年由西安出发的商旅，无论走天山南路亦或走天山北路，均在此地汇合，使这个历史文化名城成为环塔克拉玛干地区重要的商品集散地。喀什的周日牲口大巴扎也是极具特色的，未及靠近便已经见到巴扎门口尘土飞扬，一车车的驴子、一圈圈的绵羊和三两成群的奶牛交错而行， 旁边是琳琅满目的鞍具、车辕和铃铛，贩卖各种水果蔬菜的小贩大声叫卖。这些淳朴而原始的场面让来自异国的美食家惊叹不已。
This place, when you think about it, it's like, you know, years ago, they have a lot of butter trade.
Yeah.
And people were trading animals with no cash. You know, they bring cows, goat, and the same thing today we see, you know, a lot of exchanging of between animals, you know, producing all that. But of course, now they're paying with cash. But and even the cow is saying, yeah.
They're all agreeing with us. Hey, we're all there, the three of us together, traveling, discovering things, and being so happy.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
Oh, God. Yes, my friends.
Get me a knife. Hello, how are you? Look at that, isn't it exciting? Look at that, I love this man. In my head.
Assalamualaikum.
这个星期日正赶上伊斯兰教的开斋节，也是中国农历的传统节日中秋节。三位主持人在这里还有个重要任务，采购烹调原料，制作节日里的美食大餐。
萝卜1.7元，
1.7元，
啊，刚刚提到了，
挺便宜的。
Look at the grind of garlic. Oh my goodness. And so strong. A whole strip of garlic here for three yuan.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, that's it. In Malaysia, it's 1.5 ringgit saja. Ah, tengok ah, sekilo lebih garlic.
我们已经品尝了喀什的烤馕和烤包子等有名的小吃，那么普通人家的家宴又是怎样的？临近中午，我们来到一户维族人家做客，三位主持人要在那里献上具有本国特色的美食，为中秋节的家宴增添一份新鲜的祝福。
As I travel on the Silk Road and all over in China, I'm learning Chinese on the way because I want people in China to see that I'm making great deal of effort to learn Chinese. And the Moon Festival, which is like the Happy New Year for us in France, is called in Chinese.Sun Su Xie Kwa Le. Sun Su Xie Kwa Le. I'm really proud of that. I'm going to remember that and I'm going to stick in my head. Sun Su Xie Kwa Le. Voila.
维族人家和善热情的女主人接待了我们。在她的带领下，我们参观了漂亮的长廊和瓜果累累的果园。伊万的老毛病再次复发，赖在果园里不肯出来。一会儿介绍高大的无花果树，一会儿寻找地沟里的南瓜，最后终于找到了让他最为满意的紫苏。
Look at this beautiful basil. So much of it. This is what I use for my dish here. I love the taste of it. Smells so nice. Oh, it's beautiful.
伊万，法国名厨，曾与14个国家的电视台或出版社有着合作。他的厨艺结集了他周游40多个国家所获得的灵感。在这次探寻丝路美食的道路上，他更是花样百出。伊万今天最出彩的地方是大蒜的使用，在烹饪开始之前，他便烧上了整整一锅水，然后将未去皮的6头大蒜放入其中，煮了接近半个小时，然后取出后去皮，最后加入菜肴中。
And explain to the audience what
the
exactly
right
he's been boiling this garlic for
the
last 3 hours.
Leave me alone.
3 hours, okay?
All right. I've boiled this through. I've boiled a lot of garlic because we love garlic in France. I'm going to do a chicken fried with eggplants, onions, lots of garlic, tomato, local basil. Look at this beauty. I found this here in the garden, and here's a basil. They don't use it for cooking. They use it to make infusion, we say in French, like tea.All right, because it's very healthy. And I saved myself a beautiful apple, which we bought on the way. Not only one, but we bought a whole case. Beautiful apple in the place for apple, which is called Arsu. So juicy and crispy. Over to Chef Wu.
吴志宏，回族，中国厨坛的后起之秀，是名厨也是老板，在金字塔旁开设一家很受欢迎的中餐馆。 一身传统中国厨艺，又通晓伊斯兰饮食传统的他，烹饪起丝路美食可是游刃有余。
今天是咱们中国的传统中秋节，你看我穿上了我们中国人最喜欢穿的唐装，然后今天给大家中秋节做一道比较即兴的菜，就是双色双味鱼。那么我们会把一半的鱼呢，就做成这个松鼠鱼的造型，另外的一半鱼就把它做成这个五彩鱼卷了。那么这样的一个菜的有两种味道，一种味道呢就是酸甜口味，一种呢就是咸甜口了。虽说原料很简单，但相信出来绝对很好看。
Chef 王信仰伊斯兰教，东南亚家喻户晓的烹饪明星，主持过八档美食节目，主演过五部美食电影，曾经和包括文莱苏丹、前美国总统克林顿等众多名人合作烹饪秀。
Now I'm going to prepare a special dish, which is very popular also in the month of Ramadan, just everywhere around the world, especially in countries like, for example, Malaysia, in Morocco, and also in Pakistan. Now this dish is inspired, on my last trip in both countries, because we were filming for 6 weeks in Pakistan last year, and early this year we were in Morocco also for another 3 weeks. And throughout that period of time, I noticed there's a lot of common dishes that we share, even to this part of the world in Xinjiang today. I noticed many of the common spices, the way the vegetable is cooked. One of them is the famous tapanji, which I noticed they have a lot of chicken with a bit of spices, curry and all that, all being put together. Yeah. And so you throw in your onions here. And so what you need here is to saute some onion and really caramelize the onion and give that nice flavor. Now to this onion, I'm going to add some of this star anise, with a bit of garlic as well as ginger. So all these ingredients, we're going to saute them until they are really, really, beautiful and start to caramelize. And then we add here a bit of olive oil because I love olive oil and they are very healthy. So I'm using olive oil in many of my cooking in substitute to vegetable oil. There's a lot of similarity between this dish as well as the Moroccan couscous. The only difference here, we don't have some couscous. But nevertheless, the vegetables are almost the same. Yeah, when you go to France, there's a very famous dish called couscous with 7 vegetables. And these are, we use carrots, we use pumpkin. Look at that wonderful pumpkin hanging from the garden. And look at that. So, you can also use squash for that matter. And we have eggplant, and all that. We have carrots, which is very unique. Now you find here in Xinjiang, the carrot very unusual. Yeah, it's a bit whitish and yellowish, it's sweet.
I put my chicken there in the hot wok with a little olive oil, and I put the chicken first to get it a little caramelized. Now I'm going to add all my onions. They're beautiful, juicy, crispy onions. Onions and garlic are really the base of French popular food, la cuisine populaire, as we say.
现在把这个鱼的鱼刺啊，给它舔掉。舔掉了以后呢，你就给它打花刀。那么今天呢，我给大家做就是一道花色鱼菜。这花刀切法就是松鼠鱼的切法。看一下，这种做法呢，一般也就是在中餐里面比较常用。那么在国外的法餐、西餐啊，这些阿拉伯餐里，可以讲是绝对看不到这样的做法。
Now, while the onion is being fried until golden brown, as you can see, I am now chopping my tomato away because we're going to add tomato inside. Now, bearing in mind, as I mentioned just now, I am trying to duplicate a dish with a crisscross between Pakistan's vegetable dish, Moroccan couscous, and of course our Malaysian dalcha. So they're all similar. So when I think about how all this style of cooking come across from Morocco, Pakistan, and also to Xinjiang, it reminded me of the Silk Road, and of course about the spice route. Now I'm going to add in all my spices here. So we have here a bit of chili, we have cumin, we have a bit of curry powder and turmeric added, just a dash of nutmeg, and white pepper. So all now back home in Malaysia, we have what we call here our mixed curry powder mix that you can buy ready. Yeah, but here you have to mix and mix. Now back in Morocco, this is called the ras halanout. So can you imagine? Not every country has its own version, but different name. Yeah, so you make Morocco is called the ras halanout. So while I add that, yeah, I'm going to also add in my chili paste. Here in Xinjiang, they use a lot of my chili paste as well. They like them spicy, and so all the ingredients go together. And once everything is cooked, you can almost smell. So at this point of time, you can smell the spices being cooked, being toasted together nicely. And we're going to add in here our lamb. Yeah. So I've added here some bone because, you know, we're going to cook the lamb. Yeah. So you get a lot of flavor from the bones of the lamb. I'm going to put some wonderful fresh tomato. Look at that. In Xinjiang province, you find an enormous amount of vegetables. Everywhere you go in the market, you find there's plenty of fresh vegetable, yeah? Plum, tomato, fresh fruit. You know, we have grapes everywhere because the weather here is very hot, yeah? So when it's very hot in the daytime and it's cool at night, it allows the grape to really produce good content of sugar. And so the grapes are very sweet. The melons are so sweet as Chef Wang.
马来西亚厨师 Chef Wang 选用的是带骨的羊肉。首先，他把羊肉炒熟，加入他每次做菜不可或缺的各种调料。接着倒入切块的茄子、南瓜、洋葱和胡萝卜，开始像熬中药一样一味一味放入锅中，精心熬制汤汁。
And I'm going to put salt and pepper as well. I put a generous quantity of olive oil. I put a little touch more. Voilà. And the salt will help the onions to sweat and transpire, you know, like sweating. Just to be sure that we keep a little bit of that.Local atmosphere, you know, atmosphere, little spice. In France, we don't use a lot of chilies. You know, French cooking is not based on spicy food, but I love, and I did after, and I've got poached garlic, the basil, and come and have a look, Aisha is preparing for me some beautiful almond from the apricots, and I'm going to put them at the end of the dish.Thank you, Aisha.
You're welcome.
She's such a great assistant. Oh, God, I'm lucky. I'm cheating a little bit. Right now, with my French spoon, I'm going to start, look at that, mixing all this together. Voilà. The flavor is coming through. That's it. All right. And now I'm going to add all these cherry tomatoes, just to give it a bit more juice. And all this garlic that I've poached and peeled, like this.And I'll finish with my slices of apple to give it a bit more juice.
伊万今天带给我们的是一道以鸡为原料的法国大菜。他先将整鸡切块，用橄榄油略加炒制之后，加入苹果、洋葱、茄子、圣女果开始炖制。法国人的菜肴里永远缺少不了水果。
我们现在做我们第二种的做法，你看这应该是展示我们中餐的精华了。因为中餐的做法呢，就是尤其做这种花色菜呢，它很讲究刀工。那么我们刚才做的那另外一半的鱼肉呢，是做的就是松鼠鱼的花刀。那么你看我们这个鱼呢，就是待会我们要把它做成鱼卷儿，但这个鱼卷呢，还要带着这个鱼肉上面加一点盐，腌制一下。我们现在切那个卷鱼卷的丝，在西部，尤其新疆，他们很少吃这种清淡口味的菜。那么我今天呢，这个清蒸的这一半鱼肉呢，本来按照我们中式传统的做法，我们可能就不加辣椒了。但今天为了让他们也习惯于我们的这种菜呢，我就加一点辣椒。把味道改善一下，再切点姜丝，这样卷出来颜色会就好看。那么一会儿呢，我们这个菜呢，这一半鱼呢是做成咸咸口味的。做中式菜肴呢，其实原料非常简单。你看我其实就用了一条鱼，我的配料就是点小油菜。但是我相信我做出来的菜呢，绝对是色香味形俱佳。那这就是我们中国传统菜的魅力了。
哇 ，unbelievable! So his bone, oh yeah, beautiful, very technical. Yeah.
So it, you've cleaned, you've kept one fillet, take out the bone and roll it in scallops attached to it? Oh, mm-hmm. Amazing. Very interesting. Chef Wu is so interesting because he's got all these wonderful techniques of the Chinese cooking that only them know how to do so well. Chinese cooking is very technical in the cut. Everything has to be cut in a certain way. And they respect the tradition to the letter. Ooh. Amazing, I'll come back and see later.
这五分钟，那我们炸的这一半鱼头呢，你就用一下黑色的芝麻。
吴师傅精湛的刀工不仅让维族一家人大声赞叹，也让两位外国厨师大开眼界，竟然不顾节目的录制，纷纷掏出相机与松鼠桂鱼亲密合影。It is a rare thing. I'm very technical. That's why he wants so many awards. You know, it's interesting in this road program. You find three chefs. I mean, we're not competing, of course, obviously we're not competing, darling. You know, is that the true chef one? What we have is happening here is we have three different chefs coming from China. Ni hao ma from China and one from Malaysia. As we say, selamat datang ke Malaysia. To know Malaysia is to love Malaysia. We are truly Asia. To know Malaysia, to love Malaysia. It is a beautiful country, huh? I tell you, it's incredibly beautiful. Wonderful people, beautiful people, and darling, you're looking at one. And now we also have the French. Hey, bon, c'est bon? Look,
I'm putting some apricot. Hey, apricot almond. Voila. Oh yeah, we're on the Silk Road groove. Oh yeah, always on the move. And Chef Wan is so cool.
My name is Bernie.
From Malaysia and from Arab world, because Chef Wan is an expert.
No, I'm just saying.
Me?
No, I don't think so.
You hear that Frenchman?
No, nobody's talking now.
Me?
No.
Oh, now we're gonna make eggplant. I love
it. You know, my favorite, here in Xinjiang, they make fantastic eggplant, okay? Over the last few days, we've been eating eggplant and all these wonderful chili peppers. They cook it, they fry them, you know, when they're really hot and they bring out the eggplant. Then they saute garlic, they add tomato, they add vinegar. Oh, God, I tell you, and some cumin, all that is delicious, yeah? I love my dishes. It's what we call throw.
Oh, I love it.
先把这个鱼头炸一下。咱中国人一般在过节的时候啊，都喜欢做鱼，一桌人坐在一起，一般都要上一条大的整鱼。那么这样是主要是为了觉得年年都有鱼，年年都有好日子。那么今天中秋节，那我也不外乎也做一条鱼。吴师傅今天做的菜看似复杂，但是进行的有条不紊。 当卷着香菜、姜丝和红椒的鱼卷在锅内蒸制时，他迅速将松鼠桂鱼的一半入锅炸制，接着把两半做好的鱼装盘，用焯过水的油菜搭配在中间。最后，吴师傅分别制作了两种口味的汁，用番茄酱和糖制作的酸甜口味的汁淋在松鼠桂鱼上，用盐和淀粉制作的芡汁淋在蒸过的鱼卷上，这道菜就完成了。
双色双味鱼，今天中秋佳节，那么把这道菜奉献给大家，祝大家中秋节快乐。We serve this with bread and pilaf, a meal fit for the king.
You know what? The final touch at the end for presentation is very important. It has to be like something when you look at it, give you the motivation to have more of it in your plate.
Okay, now that we've completed all our dishes, we're here to, of course, you know, to meet Madame Gulbahar.
Madame Gulbahar.
And we say Gulbahar here in Uyghur, it simply means spring and
flower.
And apparently every woman with a name here has to have a flower name.
Oh.
Do you know that?
No, I didn't know.
Okay, let's meet her.
Let's go.
Assalamualaikum.
Hello.
Voilà.
Hello. Madame. Hello. Assalamu alaikum.
A present for you.
Oh, look at that.
欢迎光临。
Yes.
菜肴制作完毕，维族的女主人也为我们准备好了一桌美味佳肴。美餐过后，我们告别了热情的维吾尔族一家，在这个代表团聚的节日里继续前行。喀什离我们越来越远，但这个丝绸之路上的重要城邦，也像远远送别我们的维族女主人一样，被长久的记忆